Hi everyone, how are you today? I'm so happy to read all your comments of different parts around the world. My name is Marion from LUAN Museo Emocional. First of all, I wanted to thank all of you so much for being here today with us. It's truly, truly a pleasure for me to introduce you today to Sharonna Karni Cohen. Sharonna is an amazing person. She's born in Tel Aviv and grew up in London. She's the creator of The Big Dream. It is the largest artwork in the world, puzzled out of yoga mats, envisioning the future of countries and cities. The installation is now traveling globally, envisioning the future of the world. In 2007, she co-founded and opened Moment Salon, a pop-up cultural salon in Tel Aviv, with food, jazz, book clubs, gallery, poetry, readings, and more. Today, in this session, we will dive into our sleep and daydreams, our memories, our visions for the future, and where we are in the present day. I'm so excited for this experience. I invite everyone in this session to open your mind and open your imagination. Explore your creativity limits and let your imagination roam free. For this session, we encourage you to set phones and distractions aside, so we can fully focus on the experience. And please have near you a pen and a piece of paper for this exercise. Let's play together, let's have fun, and let's invite Sharonna so she can guide us through this magical world of dreams. Sharonna, please take the stage. Thank you so much for being here today with us.
Thank you very much and welcome everyone. So I'm just going to begin also for myself and for everyone present to just invite everyone to just close their eyes for a moment and just take a deep breath in and a deep breath out. And to just try and be as present as we can be in this virtual dream parallel world that we are about to enter. So everyone is welcome to open their eyes. So today, as discussed, we're going to explore sleep dreams, daydreams, future dreams, and collective dreams, and why dreams are so important. So we actually spend over 60% of our lives dreaming. This is a combination of sleep dreams and daydreams. So one third of our lives is actually spent sleeping, if we sleep the amount of time we're supposed to sleep, which is an average of 7 hours a night. And in that nighttime, we're dreaming a lot. And we were born to dream. And that's one third. And then in our days, according to Harvard research, we spend over 48% of our days daydreaming. So daydreaming can be when you're sitting in your car and you suddenly look outside the window for a moment when you're at a traffic light. But the challenge that we have today, more than ever, is the fact that the time we spend dreaming is actually decreasing because we spend more time on our screens than we do actually spending time in dreaming. So today is a reminder about why dreams are so important and also how much we can gain from our dreams and the imagination. So Albert Einstein did say that imagination is more important than knowledge. And that is my mantra for my daily life. And I hope it will become for all of you as well. So I will share some interesting inventions that have arisen in dreams. I will share it now. Can you see?
Yes.
So dreams as a word are considered slightly taboo often. You know, sometimes dreams are like very hippie-ish. If you say that you're interested in dreams, what does that mean? But actually, dreams have influenced every single person on this call's daily life. So these are just some inventions that have actually arisen from sleep dreams. So the periodic table, for example, Mendeleev fell asleep while listening to classical music. And in the dream, he started thinking and dreaming about all the notes, and those notes gradually transitioned into different tables and the elements. And upon waking up, he actually started working on the foundations of what we all know as the periodic table today. The sewing machine. So Elias Howe, thanks to Elias Howe, we are all wearing our clothes today. He dreamt that he was captured. And as his capturers circled him, they started stabbing him with spears. But as he noticed the spears going into his body, he noticed that he wasn't bleeding. And he noticed that the spears actually had a hole at the end of them, which managed to catch on to his clothes, and which for him was the missing solution he had for his invention that he was working on for quite a while, that then became the sewing machine. Paul McCartney came up with the melody of Yesterday in a dream. I am very curious if anyone listening actually hears music in their dreams. So you're all welcome to share in the comments. If you do, if you're able to hear music or voices, I unfortunately do not hear music in my dreams yet, but I am definitely dreaming for that day and believe it will happen. Then we have some films. So James Cameron actually was very sick while in Rome, and he came up with The Terminator. And there are many other films that have come up in dreams. And then Albert Einstein, our favorite dreamer, he actually was a lucid dreamer, which is when you're able to control your dreams and you're aware of the fact that you're dreaming, and then you can control what happens in your dream. So Einstein was sledding down a mountain, and as he looked up at the stars, he suddenly realized that they had changed size. And for him, this became the first steps in conceptualizing the theory of relativity. So dreams. I've been really interested in this subject for most of my life. And 6 years ago, I started a collective of artists called Dreamy. So we turn dreams into art. Dreams, in my opinion, are anything. It can be a thought, a poem, a story, anything that your imagination can dream up. And the goal today is really to return to that core, like our creative imaginations and how that can impact our individual lives, but also the planet. So this is an artwork inspired by a song that someone sent in that's actually very sad, but a man was on his way to visit his father in hospital, and someone had smashed into his car and stolen everything and his phone. And by the time he made it to the hospital, his father had passed away. And the title of the song and this artwork is You Stole My Last Goodbye. And this is another artwork and a dream based on a fantasy. So fantasies are also dreams, and anything our imagination can conjure. This is someone's dream that they imagined that Google will one day project mathematical equations into the stars, and that's the way we as a planet will learn math. So this is an artwork envisioning that dream, and it's a really beautiful dream and one of my favorites. And Larry Page, actually, one of the founders of Google, he came up with the concept of Google in a dream. And in the middle of the night, he imagined being able to download everything from the web and started working on the search engine the next day. And in many talks at the early stages of Google, he would actually tell everyone to keep a piece of paper and pen by your bed, because you never know what you might dream up at night. So that's definitely my first tip with this session, to keep a piece of paper or a journal by your bed, because I think writing your dreams on your phone is just a distraction. Entering your phone, which a lot of us do first thing, eliminates the dream process and our ability to collect the information we've gathered from our subconscious. And if Larry Page can dream up Google in the middle of the night, who knows what the rest of us can conceptualize. And this is another dream that I love, that's a reminder to all of us going back to the phones. This is Lindo. She's in Australia, and she dreamt that she's on her phone, constantly checking her phone, then reading for a moment, but going back to her phone. And she wanted to create an artwork to remind herself to not always be on the phone. And I might come back to this message again and again, but it is really important, because as most of us know, the average time we spend on our screens is growing. I've had days where I've spent over 8 hours on my phone, and that time on our phone, which is 8 hours of 24 hours of our day, is less time to dream and create an impact. And then lastly, our daydreams. So these are some examples of artworks envisioning people's future goals. So I love this one of Karishma, solving challenges, being the author and asking the author. So while reading, also exploring your own stories, being fearless, being curious. So these are just some goals that have been turned into art, and we'll come back to our future goals in a moment. But for now, I'd like us all to get a piece of paper and write down a dream that you've had at one point of your life. It can be a dream maybe from last night, or a dream from many years ago, or maybe a reoccurring dream that you had in your childhood. And just to write down whatever you remember from your dream. If you don't remember a dream, it can just be a dream that you have right now, something that you desire. But preferably it's a dream that you've had at night. And just to write down on the piece of paper everything that comes to you from that dream. So the location, the people, the emotions, the colors, if you hear anything in your dreams, that as well. So just spend a few moments writing your dreams. And if you're still writing, that's great. And in the meantime, for those of you finished writing, and those that are still writing, I'd like you to start putting circles around the three words that most jump out to you from that dream. So just look at the dream that you wrote down, and wherever your eyes take you is wherever your subconscious is taking you in terms of the importance of those symbols. And just circle the three words that stick out the most. There's a lot of psychologists that have explored dreams and interpretation of dreams. Obviously, Freud was one of the first, and Freud has had his own methods of analysis. I personally connect less to his analysis, but definitely don't deny that he created the foundations of dream analysis. But I think the reason I might dream about drowning is not the same reason one of you might dream about drowning. And the purpose of this exercise is actually to take inspiration from Jung, another psychologist that was very interested in dreams and dream analysis. And it's really to understand the symbols of our dreams. Sometimes the symbols reoccur in other dreams that we have at night that we don't necessarily pay attention to. So those three words that you circled, if you spent an hour just looking at those three words, your mind can take you into so many places in terms of what those three words actually mean. And I'll just go into a little bit more detail. When I started logging all of my dreams, I was constantly dreaming about one location, which is where I grew up until I was 16 years old. But I didn't notice that until I started this exercise of circling it. And only after I did that, I realized that that was where I grew up until I was 16. And I interpreted it as me lacking my youth and lacking my childhood and almost wanting to go back to being a bit more of a child and not so much a woman. I just started my company. I was going to many meetings and I was being a woman and very serious. And I'd forgotten what it is to be a child and skip and dance and giggle and be childish. And as soon as I noticed that trend, I'd noticed the 16-year-old house and I was aware of that. And I started doing more childlike activities. I actually completely stopped to dream about that location, that house that I grew up in until I was 16. So one aspect of dream analysis that you can do with yourself and really understand the significance and trends of your dreams, almost like a data scientist analyzing your own dreams, is really just noticing the reoccurring locations and really contextualizing between the dreams rather than the individual dream each night. So that's a second tip. In addition to writing your dreams down on a piece of paper, it's really comparing and correlating between your never-ending dream log that you have for the rest of your life and that you have had until today. So really looking at all of the dreams in one big picture rather than just the individual ones. And of course, the point of circling as well, these key words, is that there's so many themes and often the people in our dreams or the locations represent much more than what's on the surface. So the third tip I have when it comes to logging your dreams and remembering your dreams and most importantly, understanding them is try not when you write your dream down the next morning, try not to write it as if it's a story. You don't need to be a best-selling author when it comes to logging your dreams. You want to make sure that you're almost like spitting out as much as possible what you can remember from your subconscious. So you don't need to begin with once upon a time or last night I dreamt. Like, of course, last night you dreamt. And the essence is to really just dive straight into the details and remembering these key symbols, location, people, emotions, colors. And it doesn't need to be full sentences. It doesn't need to have a full stop. So yeah, that's the third tip. And the fourth tip with dreams from the night, REM dreams, is actually when you go to sleep in order to feed the recollection of dreams, is to wonder that night when you're falling asleep, and of course your phone's to the side, just asking yourself, will I remember my dream? The curiosity is actually what feeds the recollection of the dream the next day. So rather than saying, I will remember my dream, wondering whether you will is something that I found has really helped over the years in terms of remembering. And the last tip is the more you write your dreams down, so having that piece of paper and pen by your bed, the more you will remember them. And a lot of friends have also shared with me that when they've stopped smoking weed, they remember their dreams much more. I personally don't smoke, but I know that that also helps with remembering dreams. So if you would like to and you smoke a lot, maybe try stopping for a little bit and then seeing how many dreams come out at night to play with your life. So that's a little bit about sleep dreams. Of course, we can explore this subject for hours and days and years, but it's just a little hint to one, remember that you can learn a lot about yourself with yourself, and also what impact you'd like to create on your life and of course on our planet and with other people just from writing down what you have that comes to you in the middle of the night. And now we will go into a little bit more daydreams. So this thing that happens to us when we're just sitting in our offices or, as I mentioned earlier, in the car, in traffic. And the only tip I really have for daydreaming, and I think I'm like the queen of daydreaming because I really try to not be on my phone too much, is to create activities in your daily life that can increase your dream time. So that's something like dancing in the morning when you wake up after you've written your dreams down, to dance for 5 minutes and see where your mind drifts off when you're running. And again, when you're sitting in traffic, what I hope you'll all take away from this is that instead of going to your screen or when you're on the bus or when you're on the train, to just look out the window. I think our generation has forgotten to do that simple activity, which is looking out of the window. And especially in today's times when we're all looking at each other through this little window of virtual world, I think even more so, we need to look out of the window and remember to dream, and to see where your imagination takes you. And Picasso did say that everything you can imagine is real. And I love that quote as well, because I think everything we can imagine is real. And you should have that as a part of your daily activity to see where your imagination can go and how far it can go. So now I'm going to invite you all to actually dive into your imagination for 5 minutes and to close your eyes again. We're going to do a guided journey. And we will put on some music in the background just to add to the dream atmosphere.
Please, everyone, if you prefer to listen it with your headphones, that's better quality. If not, just turn up a little bit more your speakers, please.
So I can't see everyone, so I can't see if your eyes are closed or not, but I invite you to close them. It's more fun. And to just imagine that you are sitting comfortably, which you are already, and you're feeling relaxed. And the music can be a little bit quieter. And suddenly you see yourself, your younger self, almost you when you were 10 years old, and they reach out their hands to you and they tell you that everything is just the way it's supposed to be right now, and they invite you on a journey. And they tell you that maybe right now something technical is happening, but you ignore anything else. We don't need music, we don't need anything, we just need our imagination. And they guide you to a spaceship. Your younger self is taking you on a journey to the future. This spaceship is extremely colorful, and inside there's a really comfy chair and it has your name on it. And you sit down and you feel relaxed, and suddenly out of nowhere, the spaceship just lifts up and flies over planet Earth. You see the trees, you see the flowers, you see your home, you see maybe some friends and family. And then suddenly the spaceship goes into the stars and into the moon. And there's suddenly so many colorful clouds all around you. And you're going into the future, 5 years from today. And the spaceship slowly lands and you arrive in a place, and it says outside 2025. And the younger you opens the doors and you follow the younger you, and they take your hand again. And you see a beautiful path in front of you. I want you to envision what this path looks like. It is the path of your future. What is it made out of? How are you moving on it? Is anyone else there with you on the path? What surrounds the path? Maybe now you're moving differently on the path. And as you continue to move on the path, you feel an object in your pocket. It can be as small as a grain of sand or as big as the universe. And I just want you to imagine what this object is and what it represents from your future. And then as you continue, your younger self suddenly hands you a letter. It is written from someone in your future, thanking you for everything that you have done. Everything that you've done to make the world a slightly better place. And I just want you to imagine one sentence in that letter. What is someone thanking you for? And as you continue on your path with the object and the letter, you start to ascend and you're climbing higher and higher and you reach a peak and you're suddenly in your home. Maybe it's different from your present home, but it's your future home. Maybe you're with people that you love. Maybe you're just with yourself, smiling. And you're looking out at a beautiful view. And I just want you to imagine what it is that you see in front of you. And you feel the object again, and you have the letter in your hand. And the younger you gives you a hug goodbye. And they tell you to get back into the spaceship that's parked outside, and you sit comfortably, and it lifts off, and you go back into the stars, back through the moon. You're flying in the universe, and you suddenly see planet Earth below you in 2020, August. And the spaceship slowly but surely lands into the present day. And you're grateful for everything that you've seen from your future. And you realize that everything that you were supposed to do and everything you will do happens for a reason. And you can slowly but surely open your eyes. And I invite everyone to get their piece of paper and to write down the word, the object, the path, the letter, that sentence that stuck out. What is someone thanking you for? I just want you to write that down, and anyone is welcome to share it on the screen, to put it up with their piece of paper or write it in the chat. So for example, when I did this for myself the first time, I envisioned a megaphone. And for me, it was sort of a reminder that I'd like to share this visualization with as many people as possible to help people see their future. If anyone would like to share the object out loud with their voices and their faces, they're also welcome to. So maybe you can raise your hand if you'd like to. It's really nice to see everyone's paths. Magnet pocket watch.
I imagined being a tree, as having a tree.
Nice.
And we have other people that have said, you know, book, heart, a baby. diamond ring. The message was beauty, path with a garden, a ball of light, path of gold with flowers and bushes.
Wow, so creative, everyone.
A garden, stone, a pathway. Thank you for helping me.
Tomato.
Small stone. Thank you for making my life better. Wow, these comments are amazing.
If someone's raising their hand.
Yes.
Am I audible if someone... Hey, it's me.
Hi.
Hi. It's very nice to see you people. And the activity you people are carrying out is so, so amazing. I mean, it really has a... I am not able to tell you what I'm feeling right now. It's so peaceful. It's so beautiful. It's so relaxing. And it really is so motivating and inspiring.
Wow, amazing. Thanks so much for sharing. This is wonderful.
Thank you.
Anybody else want to share their experience? We can't hear you, Devika. Could you talk a little bit louder, please?
Are you able to hear me now?
Yes, we can hear you better. Yes.
Yeah, okay. Thanks a lot for this wonderful experience. And in such a short notice, I mean, in within few seconds, we were out there somewhere.
Oh, nice. So, you had to be here.
Yes. Firstly, I generally don't see dreams, but there was some glimpse at least that I saw previously also and right now as well. And I felt that I was just carrying a chit or a paper kind of thing, a small paper, but there were no words written on it. It was simply blank. And I was alone, I felt. And it was as if I was walking around the pool, and it was a bright day as well. And sometimes it was like evening hours, sometimes it was like day hours. But I could not see the house, and everything was, I felt I was like going under the ground because I saw lots of ground and plants and things like that.
Wow, that sounds wonderful, Devika. Thanks so much for sharing. It's amazing. What do you think, Sharonna? You like it?
Beautiful. It's so nice to see everyone's comments. And someone wrote that it was really nice to see their younger selves. And I think if we're going back to dream analysis and our sleep dreams and our daydreams, when we're children, that's when we dream the most. And part of why I brought to you all your younger selves is to remind you that, to remember that we all have our inner children, and to kind of always remember what it is to dream when we're like we do when we're young and have our imaginary friends. And, you know, part of me worries one day if because of technology, the kids of the future won't even have their imaginary friends anymore because they'll have their virtual friends. But that's a whole other conversation. I'd like now to, because we've dived into the future, go a little bit into our dream list. So our goals for the future. So get your piece of paper and pen again. Or if you're writing it in the chat, you can write it there. We're halfway through 2020. It's been a surreal year for the entire planet, maybe for the universe, we don't know. And I think now that we're halfway, it's an opportunity to almost restart. We can choose to restart every moment of the day and to just write down one word that you'd like to say more. All of these words that we're writing down now, they're part of our dream list. And when you write down your dreams and your goals, they're 60% more likely to come true if they're in front of you on a daily basis. And in Dreamy, our collective of artists, we like to turn the dreams into art, which helps even more to manifest your dreams. So you can write down one word that you'd like to say more. This is the one I wrote down. Pure. And then write down a word that you'd like to say less. So bad is a word I'd like to say less. And then you can write down a place that you'd like to travel to. It can be somewhere next door to where you live. It can be a city nearby. It can be nature. Just one place that you'd like to travel to over the next 6 months. And then one person or a few people that you'd like to spend more time with. So, family. And then one activity that you'd like to do more of for your mind. So something to help you with your mind. Mine is yoga.
Meditation for me. To do more often.
Amen to that. Everyone's writing meditation.
Yeah, meditation. Yoga as well, reading, running in the woods, painting, laughing.
I love it. Working on my pottery. Mm-hmm. Now you can write one thing that you'd like to do more of for your soul. So for example, mine is to sit on swings more. In my hometown, we have swings everywhere here in Tel Aviv. So I try to sit on swings as often as possible and just swing up and down. So something for your soul, dancing, reading.
Being in nature, dancing, reading, hiking, sky falling, smiling more. Go for trekking in the Himalayas. Wow, it's amazing. Running, relaxing and swimming. Staying underwater. Mirror affirmations. Float in water. How healing water is, no? It's insane. So, lots of people have been posting about water. Just sitting on a chair and lost in the beauty and peace of silence. Innovative writing. Reading or painting in the middle of the garden. Sharing feelings with trusted ones. Dancing in the rain. Educating people voluntarily. Wow, that's beautiful.
So nice. Shouting. And beautiful.
Yes. Feeding the fishes into the woods. Praying, reading and playing guitar in nature. Dance on a height, maybe in the mountains.
Amazing. Okay, next word is something you'd like to do more of for your body. So mine is boxing. Tai Chi.
Yes, cardio, pranayamas, playing with my pets. That's wonderful. Pilates, eating hygienic food. Working out, detoxifying, muscle building, massages, Zumba, dancing, stretching, working out, running, dance salsa, Muay Thai, wow, swimming, night swimming, running a triathlon, walking. Learn martial arts. That's amazing. Keeping healthy through food and movement.
I love it. I want to do all of them. Okay. And the last one is I want you all to just imagine one dream day that you have for the next 6 months. And what is in that dream day? Just one activity. So mine is sailing. Just basic sailing in the sea.
I mean, hiking in nature, I think that would be my one. Over here, we have walking on an empty road, traveling, eating samgyeopsal. I hope I pronounced that correctly. beach side hut with a beer, disconnecting from the world and doing nothing all day.
Playing cello in the forest is amazing.
Island hopping, I love that. Roaming in Turkey, camping, flying above scenic places. Party for a whole weekend.
Eating in a restaurant with friends, wow.
Public speaking confidently. Skydiving, bungee jumping. Visiting my family, yeah. Hugging each other without a virus. Totally. Sitting and watching sunset in Santorini. Dancing in the woods under the stars. Reading my poems in stadiums.
So we have this chat, right? We can have this chat somehow downloaded after to see that we've all manifested our dreams. That'll be really special. And I think this is the perfect transition into the last part of the section, which is collective dreaming and dreaming for the future of our planet, as much as dreaming for ourselves. So obviously, when we make ourselves a better person, we can make the world a better planet. And Jung also, who I mentioned earlier, really believed in the collective consciousness, and especially when today the world is experiencing on a whole new level something at the same time, it's an opportunity to dream as big as we've ever dreamt before. And I'm working on this project, The Big Dream, this artwork, that the goal is to collect 100,000 dreams from around the world and to turn it all into one artwork digitally with many illustrators and to project it in many cities and countries around the world. So I'll be happy to talk to everyone about it after. And for now, we'll show you just the first time we did this, and I will share with you something very magical that happened when we collected dreams and turned it into one artwork and puzzled it together with yoga mats a few years ago. So we can show you the video. That was the first time we did it, and the story I wanted to share that still gives me goosebumps to this day. So as you all understood, this was an artwork that was basically the size of double the size of a computer, was created by one of the top artists in Israel, Amit Training, and together we read all of the dreams that people sent in, And then we digitally scanned it, sliced it, and printed it on yoga mats. And in the end of June in the Middle East, it never rains. We are in the desert. And one of the dreams that kept reoccurring when people sent in their dreams is that they hope that there'll be more water and there'll be more rain. And if you will notice, there was like a huge cloud in the top left area of the artwork. And I brought to show you all one of the mats. So as you understood, it's yoga mats. So this was one of the clouds. And at the bottom of each mat, there was a number so that we could puzzle it. And we were laying out the mats. All of my friends who were helping at 6 a.m. were really confused as to why they were there puzzling this huge artwork. And out of nowhere, as soon as my friend, who was the most rational in the group, he's a neuroscientist and he's like, what are we doing here? He laid out the mat of the clouds and it started to rain. And this was the 21st of June. It has not rained in this region in over 40 years. And that date, we checked the weather. The news had just come to film us and everyone was so spooked out and it was really, really surreal. And the point of this story is that dreams really can manifest. And if enough of us have the same dreams, they can truly manifest. And that's the goal of the Big Dream, this project that we're doing around the world. And I invite you all to share your dream for the future of the planet on the Big Dream website, which I'll type here and I'll also show you all. You can enter your dream and it will inspire artists around the world who will be collecting the dreams. So if I share a screen. So you can see some of the dreams just live coming in from different places. And all of these dreams will inspire the final artwork once you've entered them. And it is actually quite fitting to share this quote that I learned about today by Galliano, who was a big believer in utopia. And I love this quote. Utopia lies at the horizon. When I draw nearer by 2 steps, it retreats 2 steps. If I proceed 10 steps forward, it swiftly slips 10 steps ahead. No matter how far I go, I can never reach it. What then is the purpose of utopia? It is to cause us to advance. And I think it's a really special quote and a reminder of utopia, of the imagination, the power that the imagination can have on all of our lives, and to collectively dream together. And if there's a few things that I'd like to invite you all to take away from this session, it's to write down your dreams when you wake up, to be on your phones less, to remember that your dreams are important. So all the beautiful dreams you all wrote down, like playing the cello in the forest and night swimming and everything else, but to also consider and think about the dreams that you have for our planet. And I really believe that if we all come together and we take this opportunity and this year to start thinking about many dreams that we all share, like peace and changing the temperatures of our planet and many other causes that we all truly care about, our imagination can take us as far as we'd like it to take us. And that's where I'd like to end today. And to just invite you all one last time to either close your eyes or keep your eyes open, but just for a brief moment to dream and to connect to your third eye. I was actually born with one in the center, and to everyone from India, I feel really blessed to actually have been born with a dot in the middle of my head. And my mom told me I was destined to deal with dreams and the imagination. And thank you all for joining, and thank you so much for inviting me to do this. It's been really fun.
Thank you so much, Sharonna. This was wonderful, and truly, yeah, I think if we don't dream about it, if we don't visualize it, no, how are we going to make things happen? So let's dream more, and let's, you know, visualize and dream about the world that we want to create and the human beings that we want to become, no, for the near future and the next generations. Thank you so much, Sharonna. We have a few questions. I don't know, Sharonna, if you have a few minutes. I know that you have to run today, but if you have a few minutes, we have some very good questions. They're asking, isn't it daydreaming not recommended for mindfulness? What can you tell us about daydreaming and mindfulness?
So I actually had a really amazing conversation with a friend in San Francisco, Jens Morgan, who's also on the board of Deepak Chopra's initiatives. And we talked about how meditation, and I know that's not completely related to the question, but it is, meditation in some ways is dreaming. It's letting your mind drift off. And mindfulness for some is about being present. But sometimes being present is about actually connecting to our past and our futures. And dreams, as we've explored in this subject, is not just about what are our goals. That was the second half. Sometimes dreams are based on our past. And of course, to be mindful is to be right here and now. But at the same time, that can just be right here and now with wherever our mind wants to take us, wherever we want to drift off. That doesn't mean necessarily, what do I need to do today? What is my to-do list? What are my action items? But for me, being mindful is sometimes letting just our thoughts mindfully drift in and out. And I think they're very much correlated to dreaming. So that's how I would approach that question.
Amazing. Very, very, very interesting. Another one, a few people mentioned that they cannot visualize, that it was very difficult for them to kind of like roam free into their imagination. What can help for them? What would you recommend?
Yeah, so I think getting a big blank piece of paper and a lot of colors. I really like these sorts of colorful pens. I think to visualize, sometimes it requires to actually be interactive. So to get a huge canvas and to start drawing wherever your mind takes you, and then to close your eyes and see where your imagination can go. I think another thing is sometimes just sitting with the sun sort of on your face with your eyes closed and letting the light almost take you to somewhere else. Music can really help, and guided imagery in general is all about returning to those symbols that we talked about with REM dreams. So letting your mind just think constantly on repeat of a place or a person, and then see where that takes you.
Amazing, amazing, wonderful. And for example, how does sleep terrors and nightmares occur? And how can we transform them into, you know, positive dreams that could help build something instead of just kind of like terrifying us?
Yeah, I think, well, for me, my whole interest in dreams started from the dark side of the imagination. So obviously there's a dark side to all of us and our imaginations and our subconscious. And I think that's why it's so important to write down your dreams and explore those key symbols we discussed. And the more you write down and interpret it and analyze it and understand with yourself, the less you are to dream those darker dreams. But the other thing that I've learned over the years is to accept that darkness, the same way we should embrace the tears when they fall down our face. I think every tear is a new creation, unlike smiles, which we each have 10 of. And I think those darker dreams that are often so terrifying are also part of what make us stronger, and also reminders of what really counts and what we really want to change in our lives. So if there's a reoccurring theme of, I don't know, terrorists or something that related to conflict, there's something going on in our lives that has the conflict, and we just need to dig deeper and sometimes dig deeper into the darkness in order to see the light, even if that sounds cliche. Obviously,
it's about the duality, no? For there to exist light, there needs to exist darkness. So the more we know our light and our darkness, the better we can become as human beings, no?
Exactly.
Amazing, Sharonna. Thanks so much. People are writing a lot about how can they connect with you. They want you back again. Here says, come again. We'll be missing you. This was the best session. Please come back. So please, could you share either your Instagram, your email, your website, whatever you feel more comfortable with, so people can follow you. And thank you so much for today. Thank you so much for this wonderful experience.
Thank you so much for inviting me.
And also thank you everyone who has joined the session today from all over the world. We had people from Mexico, USA, most European countries, India, Sri Lanka, Philippines, Pakistan, Kenya, Rwanda, India, and many other wonderful countries around the world. We encourage you to visit our website, globalleadersprogram.com and luanemotionalmuseum.com, and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn for the latest news. Please find the links in the chat window, and next week we will have available all our sessions on our YouTube channel, so you can watch them whenever you have some time available. And before closing, I would also like to encourage you to join the Art of Mindfulness series. This will be held every Wednesday, same day as today, for the next 8 weeks. During these sessions, together with illustrious industry leaders, we will explore deeply important and rapidly evolving themes. Our next session will be next Wednesday, August 19th, same time as today. We will explore breathwork and the power tools to human dignity with Nick Kislinger, founder of Breathwork and the Harvest Festival in Turkey. Breathing is a remote control to your nervous system, and when you learn different breaths, you have the power to heal your emotions. In this session, we will be guided through exercises to teach the fundamentals of controlling and directing your breath. We will also be telling stories of how breath has been a proven tool for helping relieve trauma, rehabilitate the forgotten members of community, and help elevate human dignity. Healing yourself is eventually connected with healing our community. Please click in the link that we shared in the chat to register for next week's session. And thank you again. Have a good afternoon, a wonderful evening, and a wonderful rest of the day. Stay safe and healthy, and see you very, very, very soon. Thank you so much. You guys were wonderful, and thank you so much, Sharonna, for taking the stage. It was a truly pleasure being here today with us.